Who here gets email with this fanciful things? Like, if you send, you know, this to 100 friends, Bill Gates will send you $1 million. Anybody get those emails? And you know it's not true, but some of them seem like they might be true. Like, you know, little Billy is trying to get the world record for how many, you know, get well cards. You know, so send a get well card to little Billy and, you know, in Peoria. And you don't know whether or not it's true. What I want to share with you is three things that we all know are true. I want to share with you three true. One thing that's true is my black is a little watery today, but you'll forgive me of that, won't you? True facts. So here's one that I don't know about. Here's one of those, you know, crazy ones. Someone told me in the state of Maine, if you're driving and you fail to heed one of these, what am I painting here? What is this? It's a stop sign, right? If you get pulled over by a policeman, and you get those lights that you don't want to see, and the policeman hands you a ticket, someone told me in the state of Maine it's against regulations for them to say, have a good day. I don't know whether or not that's true. That's like one of those little Billy cards. I don't know. But I'm going to share three things that we all know are true. And the first one makes me sad because I'm a daddy. And I have four kids, so this makes me very sad. In fact, do you guys want to see my four kids? This is what they look like. Do you think they look like me or my wife? What do you think? Are they beautiful children or what? Aren't they the most beautiful children you've ever seen in your life? I am so blessed, let me tell you. But, in all seriousness, I do have four kids, so the first thing that we're all going to agree on, and no one's going to argue with me, does not make me happy. And that is something that makes us all the same. Some of us are tall, some of us are short, some of us are wealthy, some of us are poor, some of us are white, some of us are black, some of us are very, very handsome, like me. I know you're all thinking that. Some of us not so handsome, like that guy right there. But what makes us all the same is that 10 out of 10 people experience death. We all die, every one of us. You know, they say that there's two things you can't avoid in life, death and taxes, and they're half right. Lots of people avoid taxes, but you can't avoid death. It makes us all the same. Anybody willing to argue with me on that? Anybody think we live forever? Okay, I've never had anybody who wasn't inebriated argue with me on that. We all agree with that. The next one is a little more complicated, so bear with me. Here's something else that we can all agree on, is that it takes smarts to come up with stuff. Like, imagine this. I want to invent a machine that takes all my papers, because I have a bunch of papers, and like a bunch of, you know, 8.5 by 11 papers, and they're a mess, and I want to put them together. I want to make a machine that takes a sliver of metal and I do this to it, and the sliver of metal goes through the paper, and it goes around on the other side, curls around, and now my paper holds together. What's that machine called? A stapler. But think about the first person that came up with that. That's pretty great, huh? Guy, pretty smart guy that came up with that? I don't know. I don't even know his name. Maybe it's Mr. Staple, for all I know. But we still use his stuff today, and there's even a store named after him, right? That takes smarts. What about this? What if I wanted to come up with a machine that, if I'm in Boston, and I want to go to France, and I get into this long tube, and I sit down, and I wait way too long, and then they give me some peanuts and a Coke, and then it makes, you know, a lot of noise, and my ears pop, and I see clouds underneath me when I look through the window, and then it makes a lot of noise, and then I'm in France a few hours later. What's that machine called?
An airplane.
But what about the first person that created the airplane? Are they pretty smart? I'd say it's pretty smart to come up with an airplane. So the second thing I want to point out is that when you see something that's made that is complicated, it means that the maker is really smart. Imagine this machine. Now this machine, no one's ever come, we haven't come up with this machine. It would be so cool. Imagine if we could take green grass, like this, this is green grass, and we could turn it into white milk. This is my milk carton. We can turn it into white milk. How good? No one's made this machine. But imagine that. I mean, there are people who are starving all over the world. Not even all over the world. In New Hampshire. And there's grass and stubble everywhere. You could go to take these machines. You could take it to Asia. You could put grass in one side. You get milk. You get cheese. You get yogurt. You get all kinds of good stuff out of it, right? It's really good for you. Imagine that. Putting green grass on one side, getting white milk on the other side. Whoever makes that machine would be a genius. They'd have their face on the front of Time Magazine, Person of the Year, Nobel Prize. You know, someone did make a machine like that, but it's not a human being. And we all know the machine. We drive by, it smells bad, and it says, Mew. Anybody know the name of that machine?
Imagine the cow! God made a cow! How cool is the cow? You put green grass on one side, you get white milk on the other side. Human beings, we can't do that molecular thing. With science can't come up with that. God made the cow. The second thing that's a true fact is that God made the cow, and he made all of us, because we're more complicated than a cow.
Guys, don't tell that to your wife. Hey, honey, sweetheart, I want to tell you something nice. You're more complicated than a cow. Don't do that, okay?
But it's true! God made the cow, and some people say that they're an atheist, and I say God doesn't believe in atheists, and the proof is a cow. Now, here's another fact that we all know is true. Again, some people say they don't believe it, but they act like it's true. Is that there's something that's in us. We have something inside of us, and it's not good. It begins with an S. It's sin. Sin is an awful thing. Some people say, Mud, really, we all sin? We go, yeah, sinning is just breaking God's law. It's like breaking the law of Hampton, New Hampshire, okay? If you break the law of Hampton, New Hampshire, do they reward you or do they punish you? They punish you, right. So sin is breaking God's law. Let me give an example. God says, you shall not lie. Can anyone here never told a lie? If you put your hand up, we can see a public liar. Never told a lie. What are you called if you tell a lie? If I lied to you, you say, Mark, what would you call me? Right. Since you've admitted to yourself we've all lied, what does that make all of us? We're all liars, right? So we've all broken God's law. What God says you should not steal. Has anyone here never taken anything that doesn't belong to them before? You've never taken anything that belongs to you? But you just admitted to being a liar, so why should I believe you? No, I'm just kidding. You know what? That's great. But you know what? You don't have to steal the Mona Lisa to be the thief. You can just take time off from a... Well, you can't do this. You're too young. But take time, you know, goof off at work and you're stealing time from a boss. Download something from the internet that doesn't belong to you. You know, God says, you shall not take the name of the Lord your God in vain. But I've never heard anybody hit their hand with a hammer and say, oh, Hitler. Oh, Osama bin Laden. No, when we hit our hand with a hammer, we say Jesus Christ or God, and then we use some word that isn't his name. You know what I mean? And that's a terrible thing. That God says that you should not take the name of the Lord your God in vain, and you will not hold him guiltless that takes his name in vain. That's called blasphemy. God's name is above any other name, and we use it to express disgust. We don't even do that with Hitler's name. And so what sin does, you know, that's only three of the Ten Commandments. There's seven more, and we're all guilty. We're all guilty, and you only have to break one. So sin separates us from God. Sin, you know, all over Hampton Beach, they have these signs, or over there, they say, danger, riptide. Okay, the reason why the town of Hampton put those signs up is because riptides are really dangerous. They can take, you know what a riptide is? Anybody know what a riptide is? It's, you know, when the current goes a certain way. What happens if you get caught in a riptide? You die, unless you can somehow swim out of it. Okay, that's why they put those signs of danger. It's not funny. Riptides are dangerous. It's bad. It'll hurt you. And God gave us 10 signs, the 10 commandments. Shall not lie, shall not steal, shall not commit adultery, you shall honor your mother and father, you shall not have any gods before me. These are signs that say sin is dangerous because riptides will only kill you. That's all they can do is kill you. Sin will kill you and send you to hell. And I'm here because I don't want people to go to the lake of fire. You don't want to go there either. So what we do is to try to make it up to God. We try to bribe God. We say, God, I'm going to be good. I'm going to work my way to God. I'll go to church. I'll get baptized. I'll do yoga, transcendental meditation. I'll become a Muslim. I'll work my way to God. I'll earn it. That's us going to God. And we can't do it because there's no way that we can earn our way to God. What we need is we need a Savior. We need God to come down to us. And that's what God did. 2,000 years ago, God came to earth. His name is Jesus Christ. Get this, he never sinned once. Never. Never lied, never stole. Jesus not like us. The Bible says he is without sin. What do you do with a perfect person that's never lied, never stole? Do you give him a parade? Do you do fireworks in his honor? You know what we did? Because the Bible says our deeds are evil, we put nails in his hands and nails in his feet. And because of us, because of what we did, Jesus Christ bled and died on the cross for us. Because sin needs to be paid for. Without the shedding of blood, there is no forgiveness of sin. And we can pay for it by going to hell, going to the lake of fire, or we can have a substitute, Jesus. Who is as good as this? Nobody is as good as Jesus, and he would do this for us. Why am I out here, like an idiot, you know, talking to people about Jesus? I know people think I'm weird. I'm here because I care. because you know we don't need an iPad, we don't need new shoes, we don't even need an apartment. You know, we can be homeless. It's not pleasant, but we can live homeless. People do it. We need Jesus Christ. If we die without him, we will get what we deserve, the lake of fire. Does anyone here know the day that they're going to die? Anybody here know the day? Again, nobody should have a hand up because you don't know. 155,000 people die every day, and many of them are healthy and young and strong. They're not all cancer patients. So I'm begging you, please consider these things. Jesus, not only did he die on the cross, but they put him in a tomb. They put a big stone over the tomb. And 3 days later, that stone had fallen away, and Jesus Christ rose from the dead. He rose from the dead. And by raising from the dead, that means he has authority. That means he's the boss. He knows what he's talking about. And he said there's two things we must do if we want our sins forgiven. And I love this, is that they both begin with the letter T. Because God makes it, he's so good that even imbeciles like me can get it. Now, what letter of the alphabet does a cross make you think of? What about you? What letter of the alphabet does a cross make you think of? A T, sure. And every time you see a cross, I want you to remember two T's. The first one is turn. Turn from our sin. Turn away from thinking that we're a good person that doesn't need Jesus. If we think, Jesus is my homeboy, he's cool, I'm cool with him. No, turn away from that thinking. Turn away from the thinking that says, I'm a good enough person, I don't need God. No, we need to turn from that. We need to repent of that. And the next thing we need to do is trust. Trust in Jesus Christ. We trust, we believe that he's God, that he's perfect, that he died on the cross, that he rose from the dead. The Bible says, if you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, then you will be saved. All that call on the name of the Lord will be saved. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him, will not perish, but have everlasting life. That God commands all men everywhere to repent. For he's bringing a day of righteousness, of judgment. Now, I'm not commanding you to repent. God is commanding you to repent. And he's God. He can do that. He can do that command. And I can't command you. I can just beg you. Please, please repent. Turn from your sin. Trust in Christ. When you do that, not only does every sin you've ever committed get forgiven, but you get adopted into God's family. And God becomes your father now. And you can have a relationship with him now. And you can read his word and grow and talk to him through prayer. It's a great thing. I have a booklet, How to Receive God's Forgiveness. I'm giving it away for free. I don't want any of your money. I don't want any of that. I just want you to know Christ because he forgave me 20 years ago when I didn't deserve it. And I want that for you. So if you'd like one of these booklets, please take one. It's completely free. And it says from the Bible how to receive God's forgiveness. There's nothing more important than that. Thank you for your time and attention, and please consider these things. I'd be glad to talk to you, and God bless you.